You're putting it right out.
Why don't you run back and get that strange and interesting new plant you've been working on? You seem
bushing. Some of these exotic plants Seymour has been tinkering with are really unusual, and we were both thinking that some of these interesting plants, prominently displayed and advertised, could attract business.
I'm afraid it isn't feeling very well today.
Yeah, that was an episode.
At least! What kind of weirdo plant is that, Seymour?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of flytrap, but I haven't been able to identify it in any of my books. So I gave it my own name. I call it an Audrey 2.
That's to me?
I hope you don't mind. You see, sir, if you put a strange and interesting plant like this here in the window, maybe
what? Do you have any idea how ridiculous you sound? Just because you put some strange and interesting plant in the window, people don't suddenly just start.
Excuse me. I couldn't help but notice that strange and interesting plant. What is it?
It's an orchid, too.
I've never seen anything like it before.
No one has.
Where'd you get it? Well, do you remember that total eclipse of the sun a couple of weeks ago? I was walking in the whole South Flower District that day.
Ship Daddy!
And I passed by this place. It was this old Chinese man.
Chang Daddy!
He sometimes sells me weird and exotic cuttings.
Ship Daddy!
Because he knows, you see, strange plants are my hobby.
Da 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 da!
He didn't have anything unusual there that day.
Ship Daddy!
So I was about to, you know, walk on by.
Good for you!
But suddenly, without warning, there was this total eclipse of the sun. It got very dark, and there's a strange humming sound, like something from another world.
Daddy!
And the light came back, there was a strange plant.
See,
she's sitting there. Just stuck in, you know, among the zinnias.
Audrey, too.
Could have sworn I hadn't been there before. But the old Chinese man sold it to me anyway.
$50 worth of roses while I'm here.
$50?
$50?
$50? Yes, sir, right away, sir.
Can you bring 100?
100? No, I'm afraid we closed the register for the day.
Oh, I guess I'll just have to buy twice as many then, won't I?
Twice as many?
Twice as many?
Twice as many?
Yes, sir, right away, sir. Audrey, my darling, kindly fetch this gentleman $100 worth of our finest red American beauty roses.
Thank you. Yes, sir. That is one strange and interesting plant.
Well, don't just stand there. Quick. I'll put that plant in the window.
Audrey, too.
Put that object through the window so the passersby can see. My God, I never believed it. My children, I'm taking us all to dinner.
Oh, I'd love to, Mr. Mushnick, but I can't. I've got a date.
Would that seem no good, Nick? You don't need a date with him. You need a major medical.
He's a professional.
What kind of professional rides a motorcycle and wears a black leather jacket?
He's a rebel, Mr. Mishnick. But he makes good money. And besides, he's the only fellow I've got. Enjoy dinner. Good night, Seymour.
Good night.
Poor girl.
Are we still going to dinner?
You're not going anywhere, Crimborn.
You're staying here and taking care of that sick plant. How come it's fainting all the time?
I told you. It's been giving me trouble. It just wilts like this. The Audrey 2 is not a healthy girl.
Well, strictly between us, neither is the Audrey 1.
Don't answer what breed is. Oh, a genus. But it's nowhere in the books.
Well, my advice to you, Crimborn, is you better figure it out and fast. Look what this exotic little beauty did for business.
I know.
So work, Seymour. There's that plant back to help. I'm counting on you.
I know.
You do?
I do.
So fix! Good night!
Tsui, I don't know what else to do for you. Mr. Mushnick and Audrey, they just met you. But I've been going through this with you for weeks. Grow and wilt, spurt and flop. Are you sickly little plant? You're just plain stubborn. What is it you want? What is it you need? Sunshine, I've given you dirt, you've given me nothing. My heart ain't getting hurt. I'm begging you sweetly, I'm down on my knees. Oh, please grow for me. I've given you plants.
Never know. Seymour was there.
December Prime.
appreciators, I slip. Lectures?
Gee.
Imagine me giving lectures. I never even finished grade school.
That doesn't matter. You've got life experience.
Some experience. I don't even know what it's like to fly in an airplane.
Me neither.
Or eat a fancy dinner at Howard Johnson's.
Me neither.
Or riding a motorcycle.
It's no big deal. And besides, it's dangerous.
It is?
Extremely dangerous. I better go fix my face. My date will be here any minute.
Excuse me, ladies. Which way to 1313 Skid Row?
I'm afraid that information will cost you a dollar.
Hey, no problem.
It's right over there. But if you'd like the thousands of others flocking down to see the Audrey 2, you better come back tomorrow, ma'am. This shop is closed today. Ooh, took his dollar.
I ain't here about posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date? You ain't by any chance talking about the girl with the black eye?
And several other medical problems?
Well, as a matter of fact...
Oh, no, this is the girl I've been beating the hell out of! What the hell is that?
Ladies, ladies, please! I'm friendly. Truce, pace them! You want some nitrous oxide?
Why don't you get lost, Vitalis Brains? The last thing Audrey needs is more of your kind.
But my kind is a very friendly kind, ladies. I'm not a monster.
What else would you call it?
I would call it an occupational hazard.
Say what?
You see, my line of work requires a certain fascination with human pain and suffering. This stuff is great. Allow me to explain. When I was younger, just a bad little kid, my mama noticed funny things I'd do, like shooting puppies with a BB gun. I'd poison guppies when I was done. I'd find a pussycat and bash in its head. That's when my mama said...
What did she say?
She said, my boy, I think someday you'll find a way to make your natural tent. Be a dandy. Son, be a dandy.
Be a dandy.
People will pay you to be inhumane.
leader of the flat.
Watch me suck up that gas. Oh my god!
He's a dentist and he'll never ever be any good.
Who wants to keep them by the Marquis de Sade? Oh, that hurts! I don't know!
Oh, shut up, open wide, here I come!
How would you like to be my son? How
would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked him much before, but Captain Captain Syndrome, I've got no choice. How much more?
Say yes, what for?
See who I want. I want to see you climbing up my family tree. I used to think you left the stench, but now I see that you're a mech, so I'm proposing be my son. Mush, Nick, and son. Sounds great. Three words with the ring knocking. So say your thing for ring with me. My lawyer on the phone.
Mr. Mushnick, don't be rash. You always said that I was trash.
No, I was joking. I'm joking. Excuse the physical expression of my cry, of the sweet paternal mission whilst I've held and dug inside.
Gee.
So?
Well?
Well?
I?
You? Go ahead and say it, Seymour. Tell me that you live.
Feed me now!
But I can't.
I'm starving.
Look, maybe I can squeeze a little out of this one, but...
I need some food!
Oh, I know, but you can't get blood from a...
More! More!
Oh, I haven't got any more! What are you going to do, slit my wrists? Look, how about I run down the corner and pick you up some nice chop sirloin?
Must be blood.
Toby, that's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
I don't want to hear this.
Feed me.
Does it have to be human?
Feed me.
Does it have to be mine?
Feed me.
Where am I supposed to get it?
Feed me some more. Feed me all night long. That's my boy.
Kill people?
I'll make it worth your while.
What?
You think this is all a coincidence, baby? The sudden success around here, your adoption paper.
Inanimate object.
Does this look inanimate to you, punk? If I can talk and I can move, who's to say I can't do anything I want?
Like what?
Like deliver pal. Let's see you get everything your secret, greasy heart desires. Would you like a Cadillac car or a shot on Jack Bar? How about a date with Hank the Bar? Gonna get it. How'd you like to be a big wheel? Dining out for every meal. While the plant can't make it over you, you're gonna get it.
Stop and think it over, pal. You got
me, Dr.
Scavello.
Do you have an appointment?
We met yesterday. Seymour Prelborn.
Oh, yes, the guy with the plant.
Right.
And the band-aids.
Right.
And the knife.
Right.
Why are you waving a knife at me, Seymour?
I'm
are you nervous about seeing the dentist?
Oh, no, I'm not nervous.
Just it. It's only gonna hurt a little.
Oh, no, you don't understand. Oh, I don't want my teeth examined.
Of course you want your teeth examined. Say ah!
No.
Say ah! Ooh, Seymour, your mouth is a mess. You got cavities, you got plaque. You're impacted, you're obsessed.
I am.
You need a complete oral examination. Let's start with that wisdom tooth.
Oh, no.
We'll just rip that bugger right out of there. What do you say?
I gotta go.
There's always time for dental hygiene. Seymour, have you ever seen the results of a neglected mouth? This could happen to you.
We could.
Unless I take immediate action. Let's get started.
Oh, wait. Aren't you gonna give me Novocaine first?
For what? Dulse the senses.
But it'll hurt.
Only till you pass out.
What's that?
That, Seymour, is the drill.
But it's rusty.
It's an antique. They don't make tools like this anymore. Sturdy, heavy, dull. This is gonna be a challenge. This is gonna be a pleasure. In fact, I'm gonna want some gas for this one.
Gas?
Nitrous oxide.
Oh, thank God. I thought you were going to use any.
Oh, Seymour, the gas is not for you.
It's for me!
I find that a little giggle gas before we begin really increases my pleasure enormously. I really want to enjoy this. In fact, I'm going to use my special gas mask. Just relax. I'll be with you in a moment.
While he's gassing himself, do a palpable super. The timing's ideal, and the moment is super. To ready and fire below this, it gathered away. Do it now, just a flicker of pressure right here on the trigger. And God, you won't have to put up with that thing for another day. Now, for the girl, now, for the plan, now, yes, I can. But I can't.
See, Seymour, I'm flying now. Ooh, the things we're gonna do to your mouth. Oh. I guess I've had about enough of this stuff. I'll just take this mask off now. Seymour? Guess what?
What?
It's stuck!
What?
The mask! It's stuck! I can't get it off! Jesus Christ, I've been asphyxiating this thing! Would you give me a hand?
Well...
Well? Well, he says. Seymour... I don't think you understand. Don't be fooled if I should giggle like a sappy happy dog. It's just the gas. It's got me high. But don't ever back to see you anymore than I could die. Oh, I giggle, I sure bear in mind I'm not mortal. But this whole thing drives me funny. Or relieved. I am sneering.
volunteers, no matter how hard you try, I've got six. Not a few ways to get recently, and you can turn it into that incredible multi-colored board. Add to number 6 weeks, girl.
Let's go.
You hope for moving your 6 weeks home pretty picture. Here it is.
Amazing.
You said it. More by some flowers.
Lift up your head, wash off that mascara.
Here, take my Kleenex.
Wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly
once a month.
What's that have to do?
Where are you going? If you want something removed in a hurry, it's best not to dispose of it on Skid Row.
What are you talking about?
This! A dentist uniform! I saw it last week and I didn't think twice.
He knows just what you've done.
Over at Dot's, he didn't say enough.
You got no place to hide.
And I catch you kissing a dentist girlfriend.
Got nowhere to run.
And I guess it looks like a motive.
He knows your life of crime.
What's he done with
you? I think it's super time.
I'm innocent. I'm innocent.
How do you explain this?
Baseball cap?
Your baseball cap. The police showed it to me and asked if I could identify it.
Well, did you?
No. They don't suspect you at all, Seymour. But they don't know about the uniform, the dogs, the girlfriend.
I didn't do it.
Then come to the police and tell them that.
He's got his facts all straight.
Just so my conscience can rest easy.
You know he's on your trail.
If you don't, I'll tell them myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
Tell them.
They're gonna put you in jail.
Okay.
He's USDA prime for my super tie.
Gonna get it, and you're a meek little guy. exciting.
I don't want to see anybody else today.
Here he is, Mrs. Luce. I found him. He's right here.
My darling, my precious, my sweet, sweet thing. So delighted to make your acquaintance. Cutie, sweetness, Seymour, baby doll. I'd like a word with you, lover. I'm sure you know me, the editor's wife. We want your face on the cover of the December 30 issue of Life.
You know the meaning.
finish my speech. Legs are torn. Give me some peace and quiet, or I'll tell him the truth.
Don't get cute with me. I made you, and I can break you.
Oh, go ahead. Break me. Do you think it's easy living with the guilt?
Oh, cut the crap and bring on the meat.
If only you'd eat me. If only you'd touch a mouse or flies. But no, you're so particular.
Come on, Crabborn, feed me. I need Ecton's Bushnick, and that was a week ago.
Just hold out till tomorrow, can you? That's all I ask. Life Magazine will be here in the morning to take our picture.
And then you'll find me somebody.
Then you'll never be hungry again. Oh, I promise.
Shelton, brother!
I know it'll die if I don't feed it in the zoo. Do you think I'm trying to think of something or someone?
Seymour! You're hysterical. What's the big deal about a little plant food? I think running this place all by yourself is too hard on you. When did Mr. Mushnick say he'd be back?
Huh?
You know, in the note that he left you. The one that said that he was in his sister's house in the...
Czechoslovakia. Right. He could be gone a very long time. Well, Audrey, can I ask you something?
Anything.
Well, just suppose for a minute that there had never been an Audrey 2. That I was just nothing again. Nobody. Would you still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
What's settled? A knife?
Tomorrow morning, our Life Magazine takes our picture and you know who bites the dust.
Seymour.
All right, they'll snap our photo, we'll be famous, we'll have a nice, quiet, normal life together. No more crack feedings, no more squalling for blood.
What feedings? What blood? You're not making any sense, Seymour. Bullets? Rives? Rat poison? You're scaring me.
There's nothing to be scared of. I'll take you away from here. Or that little development you already dreamed about. Once we're there, we'll live happily ever after. I promise. Nice little house, nice little car, no plants. No plants at all.
You're talking so peculiar, Seymour.
I'll explain everything to you tomorrow. Just go for an allergy, please.
I can't leave you in this condition.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything. Under no circumstances.
Feed me!
I will not, so stop asking!
Feed me!
I can't take much more of this. I'll run in the corner and pick you a pound of rare roast beef. Maybe that'll hold you till tomorrow.
No way.
Look, it's my last offer. Yes or no?
It's better than nothing.
Done, fine. Great. And don't think you're getting dessert.
Thank you.
all right?
Yes. No.
Please don't die. Oh, I need you, Audrey. Please, please don't die.
You know, the plant just said the strangest thing just now. It said that Orin and Mushnik were already inside.
It's true. I did it. I fed them to it.
And that's what's made it so big and strong. And you're so famous.
Doing terrible things. But not to you. Never to you.
But I want you to see
what.
Which will be very shortly. Give me to the plant so we can bring you all the wonderful things you deserve.
Oh, you don't know what you're saying.
I do. It's the one gift I can give you. And if I'm in the plant, then I'm part of the plant. So, in a way, we'll always be together. Wash my tender leaves. You'll smell my sweet perfume. Water me and care for me. You'll see me bud and bloom. I'm feeling strangely happy now, contented and serene.
Open up! No! No! Help!
Mr. Crowborn? Mr. Crowborn! All right, girls, it's very simple what we're gonna do. We're gonna take some of the small leaves, we're gonna replant them in these pots. The truck's waiting outside. Open the bin, boys! We're ready to start loading!
Similar events in cities across America.
outfit. Snowy, come on down. Snowy.
Yeah.
I'm not bad, all right?
but they kind of did it all for me. Except I just want to say a special thank you to Sarah Richmond, because she did the understudy role, so she was here like every day, and you know, some of you were some public recognition for that. Well, thank you, because this guy can throw up in the garbage can better than anybody.